I'm Aurie Swartz with Boiler Bytes. Let's see just how creative these engineers can be.
Hit it, Zach.
Yeah, let's have some fun! Inspired by cartoonist Rube Goldberg, college students compete to design a machine that uses at least 20 steps to complete a simple task. This year's task is to dispense an appropriate amount of hand sanitizer in someone's hand. I'm here in the heat of the battle with Keegan Klauke, the national chairman for the Rube Goldberg machine contest. Keegan, what exactly is a Rube Goldberg machine, and what can you tell me about the contest today?
Well, a Rube Goldberg machine is actually a machine that students build to promote engineering and creativity within the educational field. All of the students who compete in this contest also have to show a lot of teamwork, a lot of creativity, and a lot of engineering concepts that aren't usually taught in a normal classroom area. This competition is our pride and joy at Theta Tau and Purdue University. It is the one and only engineering competition where you can actually design and be creative, almost as creative as your mind can make it, in a 6-foot by 6-foot by 6-foot box.
To build a machine like this with this size, it takes a lot of time, a lot of commitment, and a whole lot of creative ideas.
The event's so fun just because who gets to build one of these things? It's not something that everyone could do it if they have the time, the effort, the parts, the materials, but not everyone does get the chance.
Normally in school projects, we have to make like a regular, you know, boring project. So with Rube Goldberg, we are able to express our creative side. And so with this, like, we can do whatever. We can do ramps, we can do pulleys, we can do catapults, you know, whatever our hearts desire. Even though Purdue and Theta Tau host the college competition, the Society of Women Engineers hosts the high school competition. So this way, they get into it as much as we do, and they work as hard as we do, if not harder. And hopefully in the end, if they do decide to come to Purdue, they'll be able to compete in some of our college competitions.
This project has actually prepared me. It taught me problem-solving skills. We didn't just throw it together and it worked perfectly. We spent a couple months tweaking it, and it taught me teamwork, working with all of these hard-working folks, and it taught me just how you can link random things together.
Some of the life skills that we learned is time management, because that's a biggie. And others are just simple thoughts, like thinking one step ahead, what's going to happen after this happens, what's another way to make this step run if we need a fallback plan.
The reason why I came out, I thought it'd be interesting to support both the college students and the high school students, because this is fun, but yeah, they kind of apply some of the engineering principles that they've learned and a whole bunch of other kind of some of their education that they're getting. So both fun, exciting for everybody, both the students who are doing the project and for the spectators.
And the first place winner of the 2010 Rube Goldberg Local Contest, the Purdue Society of Professional Engineers.
I think it's awesome that Purdue hosts this competition every year, just because Purdue is, when you think of Purdue, you think engineering. Engineering students graduate from Purdue, they're the people that companies want to hire.
So while an electric coil, a parrot, a boxing glove, and hand sanitizer may not make sense to you, it all makes sense here at the Rube Goldberg Machine Contest. For Boiler Bytes, I'm Aurie Swartz.